नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स वन एंड ऑल। आई वॉज स्पीकिंग अबाउट बॉडी माइंड एंड सोल एंड वेरियस अदर एस्पेक्ट्स रिलेटेड टू द साइंस एस्पेक्ट साइंटिफिक एस्पेक्ट्स and various other aspects which involves more or less study of as an interpersonal personality. Talking about anadi and ananta, human existence neither existed nor it can end. Atom or subatom, though it exists, it cannot be seen, it is unseen. At the same time, it cannot be ended either. Now, let's take the subject much further. The science and the rational thought. We have heard about the word called happy and gay. Now, for the viewers, for the patrons who are watching my video, here gay means I am not talking about homosexuality or the same-sex intercourse or anything like that. But here, I am talking from the rational point of view. This is as a part of note and disclaimer. Let me make it very clear to everyone. In case if anyone who is trying to take this word from that viewpoint, please understand. Now, what is this science? What is this rationality? In the good old days, when human existence came into picture, they didn't have any rational thought process. It was supposed to be developed forcibly and it had to be created at first place. And most importantly, if you see Shastras are dependent on the existence of the universe and acceptance of the universal truths. As I always keep on telling, if you defy universal laws, universal truth, you will have to face that ground reality, which is what happening today in reference to coronavirus. Now, coming to the science or the scientific part, here is where one really needs to understand. Astrology or astrophysics or astral study. Our human body, though we are talking about body, mind and soul, if you really see, it travels between space and time every now and then. At the same time, there is a concept wherein it more or less talks about the Shat Chakras or the seven chakras or the seven planets. These refer to the universal existence. However, one may ask, Rahu and Ketu being the dark planets. Here, the point is, this is where the scientific study comes into picture. And the very point for the scholars, rishis, munis, brahmarishis, or the realized souls who have produced the text from Shruti to Shrutis to Smritis had this vivid and wider vision of exposition of the scientific study. Now, in case the realized souls or the rishis or munis or brahmarishis talk directly, it would not be able, the general public would not be able to understand it. So what they did was, they divided that into the 36 chapters by way of the application, by way of the practical understanding of how exactly this body can get connected to the universal. This is one very important point which one needs to understand. That is the reason why Natya Shastra more or less talks about Rigveda, Yajurveda, Atharvana Veda, Samaveda. Samaveda talks about science of sound by way of Saptaswaras. These Saptaswaras came from the Prakriti. Prakriti had a distinct way of presenting these sounds in a rhythmic way, rhythmic and systematic way. Rigveda more or less talks about rituals wherein one person as an individual needs to do on a regular basis. This is where the practical application of usage of limbs, mudras, hastas, etc. come into picture. Atharvana Veda, Atharvana and Yajurveda talks about how medically one really would be fit. Yajurveda, this is what is called Ayurveda as well. And this is where the translation of whole of the ailments, whatever ailments that this body has, how to take, how to control, what is it that needs to be done, happens. In Atharvana Veda, it talks about para and apara vidya. Paravidya is more or less talking about the knowledge base. What kind of knowledge that you need to take, good or bad. When we talk about aparavidya is also a knowledge, but it's not so very useful for the society or as an individual. Now, I was speaking about science, right? If we really look at whole of this, this is where we need to be thankful to Vedas and Upanishads, Upavedas, the core concept of Vedas, Upavedas and Upanishads is there in Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Atharana Veda and Sama Veda. That is the reason why dance is considered divine. Because dance is having kinetic theory, body moves in 360 degrees view, and it has effect of sense of sound. Body understands the language of the universe, it gets contracted with the universe, universal truth. And the same thing if we take in yoga, it happens through meditation and yoga practice, where you put mudras and all. Right. Now, rational thought. Why this rational thought came into picture? Why am I talking about the rational thought? Man or the human existence as a social being needs to develop that rational thought process which will enhance himself as well as the society. This was what felt by the rishis, munis and brahmarishis, and that's when came Brahma, Brahma, Brahman, Tat Vam Asi, Ekoham Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi, Shiva Shakta Yukto, etc. etc. Thus, to explain whole of this concept of Ekoham Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi, Tatvamasi, they used Sri Vidya Upasana. Sri Vidya Upasana again, it talks about Navavarna. How exactly the energy source comes, how this energy can come into sync, and how exactly it travels through these chakras, and thus leading to the self-realization point, where the rationality, in the sense positive thought process that helps the society as well as himself to grow, himself or herself to grow. Dance is one medium that is more easier for that. Music also the same. And in similar way, Bhakti Tattva. Now, this Bhakti movement, most of us think that came somewhere after medieval era or something like that. But Bhakti movement was already existing. It existed even in Indic and Indus Valley civilization, Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Gupta and Maurya times also. The point is, during that period of time, things were pretty good in society. And it was under control. But as the centuries passed away, declination of the rational thought process to irrational thought process started. And the scientific reason also started evolving. The scientific analysis started evolving. That's where Acharya Charaka's advent came into picture. He explained that in various ways. Abhinavagupta, Anandavardhana, Siddhendra Yogi, all of these people, to name a few, whom people remember for their works in dance. These people explored over that and exploited that subject from the scientific point of view and the rational point of view and established that truth. From the 36 tattvas point of view of Lord Shiva. Again, one may ask and one should ask, why are you getting 36 tattvas? What are these 36 tattvas? These 36 tattvas are basically related to the universal existence or the universal universe consciousness exploitation or exploration. Unless and until these 36 tattvas come into picture, you would not be able to understand that ultimate truth. Now, would these 36 tattvas be enough? No. So, what rishis, munis, Brahma rishis, everybody thought was, we need to get into Panchabhuta tattvas or Panchakoshas, talking about the five different natures existing in the universe. Now, the moment you get in contact with that in a more positive way, what happens is these panchakoshas that are there in the body get activated. This concept which I am telling was more easier, and since I understand what really happens and what really is the structure and what really is the scheme, I am able to tell you. Not everyone would be able to understand, right? So, what rishis, munis, Brahma rishis did was, they got in the various study of the detailed study of human anatomy, taking into consideration Nadi Shastra. Nadis, which are around 72,000 Nadis, and thus out of which 16,500 predominantly work. How do they work? What do they work? What is that one medium that should be happening? We need to have signs of sound. Sound means that came from Damaruta. As per mythology, mythless eology. So that is what is there in the Shastras, that is what is there as per texts. So this further got into like 108 aksharas or whatever it is. Various different sounds came into picture. Now, it is not easier for everyone to understand those words as well, right? So, bijaksharas came into picture. These bijaksharas, one word or two words formed are equivalent to 25 words or 30 words or one sentence. So this is where Samaveda came, lyrics and poetic expressions. Now language. there has to be some medium, right, for anyone to translate that what you call universe or atmospheric language. So what they did was they came up with classical Sanskrit words. Classical Sanskrit words or some words that could indicate or create that meaning, which are used in the lyrics in the poetic format or thematic format. So if we really see whole of the story which I told, it is going to the rational thought process only in the end. Whether he or she, himself or herself, what happens is, the moment he or she follows whole of this process diligently and understands the subject to the deeper level, he or she will be able to reach that highest consciousness state. This is what we call beyond Sahasrara. At the same time, it is touching upon the scientific study. When I say scientific study, from the astral point of view, touching upon the, you know, it is touching when a body, when an individual dances, he or she gets in touch with the space and the time with which an individual, himself or herself, touches and try to contract, that's when the thought process starts happening. And that is where yat bhavam tat bhavati comes in. Whatever bhavas or anubhavas, when I say anubhavas, anu plus bhavas, anu means something related to atomic. Atom is the minutest creation in the universe. It is neither created nor destroyed, but still exists. It neither dies as well. This anu or paramanu, to understand this, emotions need to get developed. That is what is called bhavas. Bhava. The resultant output of that comes due to the actions or due to the hearing of the sense of sound and exhibiting that, and thus whole of this goes to that level. This is what is called anubhavas. Bhava. Bhava plus anubhava. Bhava plus anu plus bhava. This further leads to the self-realization. Think about it. So that is the reason why classical dance or the classical music, whoever is learning, has that scientific approach and the rational thought process which indirectly happens. Though one may argue that the scientific approach or the rational thought process is not there. Everything is one. I don't agree to that. At the same time, I agree to that. But it requires certain process to understand. Think about it. This is again an open-ended question to the researchers, scholars, research scholars in dance and music. Not only that, art and culture, fine arts, yoga, yoga therapists, someone who is doing research in Vedas and Upavedas, Upanishads. In case, if my argument is wrong, please do let me know. Because everything has a scientific reason and the rationality behind everything. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive one. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. May the Guru's grace be with all. Have a nice day ahead.